Alabama has always been known for the gritty sports like football and auto racing and names like Bear Bryant and the Allisons. But recently, the Yellowhammer State, and in particular Talladega County, has put out a famous name of a different sort. Gerald Wallace. Although many fans know Wallace as an amazing jumper, his early years were far from grandiose.
When Gerald was first born, Gerald was a sickly baby. Gerald liked to die on me at least twice, because he got that sick. Everything that he would drink, any type of milk, he just couldn't keep it in him, and he was getting dehydrated.
But once he weathered the storm of childhood illnesses, the former baseball standout turned hoop dreamer was just like any other kid. And in a small town like Childersburg, Alabama, there are plenty of stories to tell.
He kept things exciting because he was a good.
Oh, we fight still today. We get into it every summer, but yeah, he's a big bully.
He's very playful. That's what everybody's saying. He's a bully. I would call it a bully. I think he's openly playful.
Ain't no bullying, man. He's rapping, having fun. There ain't no bully. Everybody say I'm a bully. I ain't no bully. Just wrestle and have fun.
But Gerald had a serious side, too, especially when it came to education and his career in basketball.
Gerald, as a student, always took pride in his grades. He always took pride in getting the best grades he possibly could. He's very smart. He did really well with the ACT test. And he also, one of the biggest things that I can remember, that he always would get up and come to school. In 12 years, he never missed a day. So that's very impressive to me.
I broke my arm one day, and Mom tried to make me stay home. I wanted to go back to school. I wanted to stay at home.
As far as athleticism goes, he is a great athlete. I've seen Gerald throw a football 75 yards. I've seen him, I know for a fact, he could throw a baseball in the low 90s from the pitcher's mound. He's a great athlete, and he could have played Division I sports in any of the three sports, baseball, basketball, and football.
And even when NBA scouts were knocking at Wallace's door, Gerald's mom made sure that he remained grounded.
And I told him, you go 1 year, and if you don't like it, and you want to come out, then I'll be 100% behind you, whichever way you decide to go. If you want to change schools or go pro, it will be fine with me, but just do 1 year for me.
Gerald turned pro after only 1 year at the University of Alabama and spent much of his time with the Sacramento Kings on the bench. But since being drafted by the Bobcats in the 2004 NBA expansion, Wallace has become a human highlight. Nonetheless, NBA fame hasn't changed Gerald Wallace. He still returns to Childersburg to spend summers in the home he grew up in with folks who couldn't be more proud.
I am too proud. I mean, I can't even put it into words.
Oh, I'm extremely proud of him. I mean, he's always done well. He's a good kid.
He plays pickup games on the same courts he honed his skills as a teenager. And when the sun begins to set on Childersburg, Gerald spends that time with his three children and the family and friends he'll always be close to.
This is where I grew up at. This is all my family. I don't have any family in Charlotte or anywhere else. All my family is right here in this one neighborhood. I don't even have to go out of the neighborhood. All my family is right here, really. You know, it's fun to come home and just, you know, go to a cookout, you know, a barbecue, you know, go out and just hang out with people. So that's what I try to do.
Gerald.